If an external magnetic field is applied to a ferromagnetic specimen, two things can happen according to the domain model. The domain parallel or nearly parallel to external applied magnetic field can grow in size at the expense of anti-parallel domains. Means anti-parallel domains, they give the energy to the domains which are parallel. So parallel domain grow in size and anti-parallel domain decrease in size. To what parallel? Parallel to the external applied magnetic field. These are domains direction, which are this is the direction of external applied magnetic field H. So domain parallel to the external applied magnetic field will grow in size at the expense of the domains which are not parallel to the magnetic field. These domains decrease in size and these domains increase in size when we apply external magnetic field. This is one possibility. And when all the domains are parallel to the external applied magnetic field, all domains become aligned and ferromagnetic material become magnetized. This is the one way. And the second way is magnetic moment of the domains can rotate in the field direction. We have the material in which the magnetic moment of domains are in different directions. When external magnetic field is applied, these are direct, these double moments of the domains direct towards the direction of external applied magnetic field. And in both the cases, parallel domains grow in size or the magnetic moment of the domain orient themselves towards the direction of external magnetic field. In the both the cases, magnetic moments are aligned and the material become magnetized. A material that is magnetized has always magnetic moments in one direction aligned. The magnetic moment of the domains can rotate into the field direction. The magnetic moment may be in different direction, they will rotate in the direction of field. In either case, the sample requires a magnetization and which increases as the field increases until all domains are parallel to the applied field. When the external magnetic field is increased, the time reaches when all domains are parallel to the applied magnetic field, at which point the material is said to be saturated and the magnetization is equal to saturation magnetization. Mean the maximum when all the domains are parallel to each other and they are parallel to external magnetic field and no one domain is in other direction, and this magnetization is called saturated magnetization or saturation magnetization. Small regions, ferromagnetic domains. We have already studied about the domains. So here, ferromagnetic domains, small region of spontaneous magnetization formed at temperature below the Curie point are known as domains. Here the big domain is shown. This domain is divided into two domains and then it is further divided into smaller domains. In each part, this is a smaller portion domain. Individual magnetic moments, there are many individual dipole. This is the this black one is shown the grand dipole moment, some of the all dipole moment, magnetic moments. So individual small magnetic moments all are parallel to each other and aligned, and this black is the resultant of all individual atomic magnetic moments, which are all aligned. So in this small region, all atomic magnetic moments are aligned to each other. So where the magnetic moments are aligned, that region is called magnetized region. So spontaneous, small region of spontaneous magnetization formed at temperature below the Curie point. We know that below the Curie point, these spontaneous magnetization exists, and above the Curie point, ferromagnetic material becomes paramagnetic, as known as domains originate in order to lower the magnetic energy. These magnetic domains, if the magnetic domain number is large, magnetic energy will be lowered, and every system is stable when its energy is lowered. When these domains are becoming smaller and smaller up to some limit, when its size is reached up to some limit, then it further not subdivided into even smaller units. When subdivision is complete, a state is reached in which further subdivision would cause a greater increase in exchange energy. Exchange energy mean here, exchange energy mean as like which is an electricity, the equal charges repel each other, electrostatic energy. Here is exchange energy. Two domains will repel each other and their exchange energy will increase as the size is decreased. So further size does not decrease due to this exchange energy. It would cause decrease in field energy. It would cause decrease in field energy, and ferromagnet would assume this state of minimum total energy. So up to a certain size, ferromagnetic domains subdivision become stopped. There is no more subdivision into even more smaller parts. Why? Because this exchange energy is increased and it stop further subdivision. Here the magnetic domains are shown. These domains are magnetic domains, and in each domain the individual magnetic moments are parallel to each other. This is the resultant magnetic moment of this domain, which is triangular in shape. The domains may be in other shapes, and one domain and the other domain magnetic moments are in different direction. This is growth of domain parallel to an applied magnetic field. Here we are not applying a magnetic field in figure A. This is small domain, large domain, large domain. And when external magnetic field is applied in this direction, when it is applied in this direction, the individual domain magnetic moment will become parallel to the external magnetic field. You know, you can see this small domain disappear. So large domains grow in size at the expense of small domains. Small domain merge into it, and all the line of force magnetic moments are parallel to applied magnetic field, and time reaches these domains will also be in the direction of applied magnetic field. And when all are in the direction of applied magnetic field, and then saturation magnetization is reached. So in normal crystal the domains are in random direction, but when magnetic field is applied, all the domains rotate in parallel position to the applied magnetic field. Antiferromagnetism is exhibited by manganese oxide. Here the smaller ions are manganese ions. Magnetic moment of manganese ions, one manganese ion, you know, it is upside arrow direction, downside arrow direction. These both are anti-parallel to each other, and this one is parallel to each other. So the spin moments, half are parallel, half are anti-parallel. So they cancel the effect of each other, and overall magnetization is zero. Spun moment of the neighboring atom are ordered in an anti-parallel arrangement, exhibited by some metals, alloys and salts of transition metal, in which the atomic magnetic moment are sufficiently low temperatures or an ordered array with alternate or spiral so as to give no total moment in zero applied field. When no magnetic field is applied, the total magnetic moment of the material is zero due to parallel and anti-parallel spin moments or magnetic moments. This is for anti-ferromagnetic. When a magnetic field is applied, a small magnetization appears in the direction of the field, which increases further with temperature. We know that in the anti-ferromagnetic material, the atomic spin states are anti-parallel. But when external magnetic field is applied, H, some of these spins which are anti-parallel, they rotate themselves towards the magnetic field direction. In this way, a small magnetization appears in the direction of field. And this magnetization increases by increasing temperature. More number of parallel magnetic moments. And such a behavior is observed in anti-ferromagnetic material. Behavior means the magnetization of anti-ferromagnetic material increases by increasing in temperature. And the highest magnetization is at temperature. The temperature is called Deal temperature. The highest magnetization takes place at a temperature for the anti-ferromagnetic material, and the temperature is called Deal temperature. Ferrimagnetism. In some compound, for example, in some ceramics, the continuously atoms may be antiferromagnetically coupled but with different magnetic moments. For example, here in this example, this is upward direction, this one is downward direction, upward, downward, but the magnitude is different. The lower one has higher magnitude, the upper one has low magnitude. So they do not totally cancel the effect of each other. And these type of materials are called ferrimagnetic material, and this phenomena is called ferrimagnetism. Different magnetic moments values. This would give rise to a net magnetic moment in each coupling, and the sum of the moments of all the coupling could result in magnetization. So overall, this material will have some magnetization, which is comparable in order of magnitude to ferromagnet. This phenomena is termed as ferrimagnetism. Like ferromagnet, they are spontaneously magnetized to some extent. So these type of materials are called ferrimagnetic material, and this phenomena is termed as ferrimagnetism. The distinction between the two, but difference between the ferrimagnetic and ferromagnetic material is that in the source of the net magnetic moment, the net magnetic moments are smaller in ferrimagnetic material as compared to ferromagnetic material. This type of magnetism occur in materials such as ferrites, which are basically the oxides of various metal elements. Example is ferrite. These ionic material may be represented by chemical formula. This is the ferrite chemical formula. Here may be some metal like zinc, copper, etc. So it is basically metal iron oxide, in which the M represent any of the several metallic elements. The prototype ferrites Fe3O4, these are different ferrites, and the sometime also called iodine stone, and these are ferrimagnetic materials. Mineral magnetite is called iodine stone. This is ferrimagnetic material. This is again ferrimagnetic material. The iron 3 ions, iron 2 ions, and oxide ion. The spin magnetic moment configuration. Magnetorestriction. The change of length of a ferrimagnetic material when it is magnetized is called magnetorestriction. A small change in length takes place when a material is magnetized, and this change in the length of the material is called magneto restriction. More generally, it is the phenomena that the state of strain of a ferromagnetic sample depend on direction and extent of magnetization. When material is magnetized, a strain develop in it, and the strain depend on the direction and extent of magnetization. The phenomena has an important application in magneto restriction transducer or signal converter, which convert the other type of signals into the electrical signals. Magneto restriction of some common material exhibiting expansion and contraction. Some material expand and some material contract. Magneto restriction and nickel contract. Cobalt has very little magnetic restriction. And iron. And iron size increase when it is magnetized. The influence of temperature on magnetic behavior. For ferromagnetic, antiferromagnetic, and ferrimagnetic material, the atomic thermal motion counteract the coupling forces between the adjacent atomic dipoles, thereby causing some dipole misalignment regardless of whether an external magnetic field is present. So what happens? When the magnetic line of force are when magnetic moments are parallel to each other, when there is no external magnetic field, like in case of antiferromagnetic, ferromagnetic, and ferrimagnetic, when temperature is increased, motion of atom increases, and due to this motion, this alignment may be disturbed. Counteract the coupling forces between the adjacent atomic dipole moment, thereby causing some dipole misalignment. Magnetic moments may change the direction. Misalignment takes place regardless of whether an external magnetic field is present. In absence of external magnetic field, increase in temperature cause misalignment, or in the presence of magnetic field, this misalignment can also take place. There is a result in a decrease in saturation magnetization for both ferro and ferrimagnet. Magnetization decreases and saturation magnetization also decreases. The saturation magnetization is a maximum at 0 Kelvin. Magnetization decreases, saturation magnetization decreases when increase in temperature, so it is increased with decrease in temperature. So 0 Kelvin is the lowest temperature, so saturation magnetization is maximum at this lowest temperature, at which temperature the thermal vibrations are minimum. The vibration are minimum, so there is no disturbance of this alignment is 0 Kelvin. With the rise in temperature, the saturation magnetization diminishes gradually and then abruptly drop to zero, what is called the Curie temperature. We have studied already that below the Curie temperature, the material is ferromagnetic. And when these magnetization diminishes and Curie temperature is reached, the material is no more ferromagnetic. It becomes paramagnetic. Antiferromagnetism also affected by temperature. At nil temperature, this behavior vanishes. For antiferromagnetic substances is the nil temperature. So at nil temperature, this behavior vanishes and the alignment of magnetic moment vanishes at nil temperature. Above the nil temperature, the material becomes paramagnetic. Above TN, antiferromagnetic material also become paramagnetic. So for ferromagnetic material is the Curie temperature, and for antiferromagnetic material is the Neel temperature. Here in this graph, it's shown saturation magnetization versus temperature. This is on y-axis is saturation magnetization. When the temperature is increased, saturation magnetization decreases. Domains and hysteresis. When ferromagnetic sample that is initially demagnetized is subjected to continuously increasing magnetizing force H. The relationship between H and flux density is shown by the normal magnetization curve OAB. This is OAB, this curve. So here at the O, the external magnetic, this is H is external magnetic field. When we apply external magnetic field to a ferromagnetic material, a magnetic flux B is produced. So by this is demagnetized. Zero external magnetic field is zero, magnetic flux is zero. When we increase H, B also increase up to this width. So this curve O A B show normal magnetization curve. When we increase the external magnetic field, the material is magnetized and it acquires some value of B, magnetic flux density. So here in this diagram, we have studied that when we increase the external magnetic field, the ferromagnetic material become magnetized, and here at this point, its magnetic flux density becomes equal to Bm. Or in other words, we can, when we increase the H, B increases, and up to this point, the B value is Bm. But again, when we decrease the H, the line does not follow this path. The line follow a new path, that is this path. That is B, C, D, this path. So when we decrease the H, when we decrease the external magnetic field, the magnetization is also decreased. But here the magnetization will not be zero. External magnetic field is zero here, but B is not zero here. Means magnetic flux density is not zero here. Because it is ferromagnetic material, and ferromagnetic material, when a ferromagnetic material is put in an external electric field, its magnetic dipoles align themselves, magnetic moment align themselves, and when we remove the external magnetic field, the ferromagnetic material become magnetized for some time. So there it is magnetized now, and its magnetic moment is not zero, its B, magnetic flux density, is not zero. Okay, when we decrease in towards the magnetic field towards negative side, that's we reverse the magnetic field, external applied magnetic field direction. Here the magnetic field is zero, now we are reversing the external magnetic field direction. By reversing the external magnetic field direction to the negative side, B decreases, and when the external magnetic field value is minus HB, the material becomes demagnetized. Its magnetic moment becomes zero, its magnetic flux density becomes zero. When we further decrease decreasing the external magnetic field towards negative direction, towards opposite, we are actually increasing the external magnetic field towards opposite direction, so it is called negative direction. The B is now in negative side. The magnetic field is magnetic flux density is negative side and reaches up to this minimum value. Then after this, we are increasing the external magnetic field in the positive direction. So magnetic field is when increased, the B also increase, and B here reaches, here the B values are negative, so here B reaches 0, and then by increasing further the B become positive and again reaches up to point B. So this type of curve is called hysteresis curve, because when we go upward and then go in reverse direction, the line not follow the same path, it follow another path. We are going back to this path and we are going up to this another different path, and this type of curve is called hysteresis curve for ferromagnetic material. And the reason is that ferromagnetic material become magnetized when we apply external magnetic field, and they remain magnetized even if we remove the magnetic field. If the value of H is further reduced from H1 to 0, here is H1 and we are decreasing the value of H from H1 to 0. Then for 0, the value of B will be BR. The specimen has retained a permanent magnetism. So here is BR because specimen has permanent magnetism. So its B value is not 0. The value of may be reduced to 0 at E by reversing the direction of external magnetic field and increasing its value of HC. So it can be demagnetized by reversing the direction of magnetic field. So here is negative direction mean reversing of the direction of magnetic field. So this value of HC is called coercive force or coercivity. This HC value is the reverse magnetic field value when the ferromagnetic material is demagnetized and magnetic flux density becomes 0. So this HC value, external magnetic field value, is called coercive force or coercivity. As H is increased in negative direction, so here the H is increased towards negative direction, or we can say it is further increased in opposite direction. The magnetization proceed along the curve of figure shown here when it is further decreased, but opposite until at F, the value of B and H are the same as those at B. Here the value, here the value of H and B are same, here the value of B and H are same. But what is the difference? Here the H value is positive, here the H value is negative, and B value is also negative. And this entire loop is called hysteresis loop. The same type of curve, soft and hard magnetic material. Can be easily, soft magnetic material can be easily magnetized or demagnetized, and here is the opposite case, they cannot be easily magnetized. Soft magnetic material show thin and long hysteresis loop, hysteresis curve. A wide hysteresis loop is shown by hard ferromagnetic material. High permeability and low coercive field hai. Low permeability and high coercive field, low flexibility and low permanent magnetization, small susceptibility and high remnant magnetization. If the area of loop is small, magnetic energy loss per volume is less during magnetization and demagnetization. Here is the opposite case. Application, electromagnet in motor, generator, dynamos and switches circuit. Example is iron silicon. Here the application is for permanent magnet in speakers and clocks it is used, and examples are manganese, iron, nickel, rare earth alloys. Here are some of the applications. The magnets are used, magnetic material are used in audio tapes, VCR, computer hard disk, floppy disk, credit card are few examples of magnetic storage. In computers, semiconductor elements are with primary memory and magnetic disk are used for secondary memory because they are capable of larger quantities of information and also at a lower cost. The recording and television industries rely heavily on magnetic tapes for storage and reproduction of audio and video
sequences. So these are some of the applications of magnetic materials.